What is your goal for this year?
Hello, what's up, people? I'm sick as fuck. I'm sicker than a mug, but you know, I know, people, I just filmed the narrative part of yesterday's vlog. It's still crazy early, so that's why I'm being quiet up in this bitch. What I'm doing now is I'm gonna have something really quick to eat, sandwich, go upstairs, edit this video, get it up. I have a feeling it's gonna be up a little bit later than the usual. It is a Sunday as well, so it's more of a chill out day. We do have shoulders and arms on the cards. For this vlog, lads, relax. Sit back, get in that cozy mood, and just chill out. Some Sunday chill vibes. Still haven't got this video up. 18 minutes left. And then we're going to go and train, lads. I decided that because today is going to be like a really slow chill out Sunday for me, that I'd gather questions on Snapchat. They're coming in now. And I'm just answering them throughout the day. Anyway, these questions are coming in. I'm going to wait for that video to finish rendering, upload it, and then we'll get started with the questions. Finally, it's up. Fellas, I'm going to kick off the questions, okay? We got a lot. A lot. Question number one, best way to recover from minor injuries. Rest, motherfucker.
We have another one. Between you, Sean, Kyle and Alex, who has the highest bench press, deadlift and squat? I have no idea.
Here's a good one. If you're looking to get lean for the summer, when's the best time to start cutting? I'm sure that would vary no matter who you are, lads. It depends on what your goal is, how high your body fat is. What else would come into account? There's so many factors. How quick you lose weight. If you want to get shredded for the actual, like, period of time when everyone's hitting the beach and I'd say start cutting about March is probably a good time to start. Just pulled up to the gym, people.
Yeah.
Gonna bang out another question really quick. Don't fall. Bang out another question really quick before I go on. Smash up some weights. Okay. What is your goal for this year? I'm gonna say a goal fitness related and then a goal just life related. Goal fitness related, by the end of 2018, I wanna bench 4 plates. That's just a huge goal. And then life related, I would love to leave this year having this channel up close to 50k, if not over 50k subs. Like, that's what I'm gonna grind towards. That's like the vision that I'm gonna just chase every day. You baby? You baby?
Aye.
That was a sick session. Right, before I get started, you might as well knock out a couple Q's. Q stands for quantum physics, okay? Man, that was a sick workout, seriously. Okay, where were we? Do you train abs? If so, how often? Because you never show it in the videos. I do train abs probably twice a week now. Never show it because I'm just completely burned out by then. Whoever I'm usually training with usually goes and does their own thing at that point, so there's no one to film me. But I do train abs. They are important to train on a bulk like any other muscle. How much does Ellie bench? Somewhere close to 75 kilo, probably. This is a good one. If you're new to training, how do you decide whether you need to bulk or cut? It really depends, lads. I would say no matter where you are, unless you are overweight, like really overweight, I would just bulk for a year. Keep it as lean as possible. Even tidying up your diet, you'll notice some fat loss in the process of building muscle for a beginner anyway. You're in that noob gain stage, you feel me? So I'd say if you're overweight, cut. If you're just a normal everyday lad or woman, bulk.
Wow, I don't think the camera will do it any justice. But the sky is beautiful as
it's a good one. Is it good to take rest days? Rest days are so important. Almost as important as ass.
If I had to choose big arms or big legs? Man, I want some big arms. Just about to whip up a curry, people. Anyone wondering what sauce I use? This is the sauce. Anyone wondering where you can get it? You can get it in Eurospar. I have not found another place yet, but I'm sure it's all over the Kipna. And if they don't sponsor me soon, there's gonna be trouble. Big trouble. Bam, I'm about to grab a shower real quick, lads, but I'll bang out another quickie.
Okay, this is a good one. Is diet that important? And if so, is it important in getting stronger quicker? Diet is 80% of any of the gains, strength, or muscle growth that you will obtain from the gym. Would you say fitness and the gym has changed how you mentally approach or look at things in life? 100%. I think the gym teaches you discipline. It gives you a taste of what achieving small goals feels like, so it gives you bigger aspirations in life. I mean, setting small goals in the gym and obtaining them, it's orgasmic. So you get addicted to that feeling, and that sort of crosses over into like your personal life and goals you may set. I think the structure of it is what I really like about it. What I really like about going to the gym and taking it serious is because it builds character. Like, I am Batman. Is it true that the snap hoodies increase strength gains?
Yes.
Right, people, I'm gonna go and take a shower because I smell like ass.
It's not weird if I review my own videos 8 times, is it? I think it's a good sign though if you can make a video and actually sit through it and watch it all once it's uploaded. It's a good sign from God.
Back in the room, straight chilling, munching on some toast with some jam and some protein. Let me pull up a question. A question. Let's get deep, okay? Let's get deep. Deep inside. When did I start going to the gym? Joined the gym 16. Obviously, you're not allowed in younger. But I'm working out since I'm about 14. Have you any useful tips for building strength on the bench press? Technique, repetition. A lot of people go in, switch up their form every week. They're not really hitting calorie intakes. They're not being consistent with the bench press, if that makes sense. You don't want to overdo it though, because that's just the complete opposite. Here's a good one. What's up, Glenn? I've been training for over a year now, seeing great progress on all my muscles, bar my chest. I'm able to lift heavier, but it doesn't seem to be getting any bigger. Any advice on what to do? You're probably not hitting muscle hypertrophy, or else your diet isn't on point. It's definitely one of them two. You could be getting stronger. You can get stronger on maintenance calories. It's not impossible, but if you're not gaining any size, or it's just your chest, then you need to work on technique and form, and probably switch around your routines, because you're probably arm dominant or shoulder dominant or something like that. So I'd say, take a step back. Lighten the weight, really feel your chest workouts on your chest, and you're good to go. You damn me?
Alright, people, we need to run somewhere really quick.
I have to fly off really quick down the shop just to grab a few bits, and I'm gonna answer the last few questions before I go so we can wrap this up. Again, people, let me know if you want me to throw a Q&A in just a day where it's just questions. Because as these videos go on, we're getting more subs, we have more activity on the channel, and we have a lot more questions in the DMs, along with some ass pics and some nipple pics. You feel me? Anyway, I have 2 or 3 good questions that I said, yo, hit me up. Couple more questions so we can wrap this up with something tasty. Something as tasty as an enchilada. That's what I'm talking. When Ellie moves, will you visit? Do fishes swim? Will you ever open your own gym? If life allows me to, if I can make it. If life allows me to, if I make it big time, then I will definitely open a gym. Pull a Bradley Martin on your ass. Basically, how many subs will you need before you feel financially stable and okay to move into your own house? That is a good question. Lads, think about it. I have 12,000 subs just about. If I haven't got 12,000 subs and you're watching this right now and you see me not having 12,000 subs, go like make your nanny an account and just come and subscribe to my ass, you feel me? But that is a good question, mate. And it's the way you go about it. You can have 100,000 subs but not optimize what you actually have there and capitalize on it. I feel though, any channel with 50,000 subs, 50,000 real fans, followers, has the opportunity to capitalize and sell merch, sell a service, aka online coaching, all that good stuff. Everyone would be different, man. I feel like when I reach 50,000, I will be financially stable to probably like live out of a house or rent a house or something, or an apartment, something small. Anyway, dudes, that's the video. Hopefully yous are enjoying these daily videos. They are getting a little hard, I'm not gonna lie, but I'm gonna pull through, pull out at the same time. Pull out game hella strong, if any. Subscribe to my pull out game. Anyway, fellas, it was a chill out Sunday for me. All I done really was relax. I didn't want to run around and vlog a lot. But do let me know if you want to see one of these a week. I do have some cool videos coming soon. Please, if you haven't done already, pick up a snap hoodie and subscribe if we are not at 12,000. Hopefully. This is going up at 9:30 tomorrow, so hopefully we do. I forgot to say in the last video, you smart chill a bit of six. In the next one. I don't got reason to lie. I don't need your drama. I don't need you to survive. You don't got to say it, 'cause I know that you don't like me.